Hello to all. My pleasure to be speaking at TSIA in front of a big crowd. As you can hear, I'm French, and I'm trying to bring you into the story of what happened at Schneider Electric using basically digital as one tool to improve the use of electricity. Where I'm going to start with is 20 years ago. Okay, at that time, me, I was in China working very closely with a team here in US. And what we had as electric and digital capabilities were pretty simple. You see it illustrated. We had a set of meters that were basically connecting to SCADAs or power monitoring system. That was basically our offer. And at that time, the tension of energy usage started to raise in some customers, and we were seeing that basically we had requests from a few customers saying, hey, we would like to improve our energy footprint, and in order to improve, we need to measure, because if we don't know where we stand in terms of energy usage, we don't know how to improve or where to improve. So basically, we had people that were coming to us, to Schneider Electric, saying, hey, we need your help. We need to measure energy. And that has been the first stage of our journey in what we call energy efficiency. You will see that it brings us pretty far because we are now positioning ourselves as a company in sustainability. But we started with something that was pretty simple, that was let's offer capability to our customer to measure where they consume, where they spend, and where eventually they can save energy. We didn't know, honestly, 20 years ago, and I've been part of this journey and pretty humble on each of the steps, we didn't know where it would bring us, right? We simply knew that electricity was probably a good source of energy in terms of CO2 footprint. This was pretty obvious at that time. And we knew that there was incredible potential of savings at the consumer point, right? And our first experiences in buildings, when we started to implement the solution of monitoring of electricity or monitoring of gas, is that the people who were looking at their bill and the monitoring, they were able to save 30%. So we say, hey, there's some things to do there, right? We probably can help many people in saving their energy, and that's where we started. If we look where we are today, it's now becoming pretty obvious that electricity and digital are converging together. That's pretty obvious for two reasons. Is that if you want to introduce green generation, in most of the cases, you cannot supply 100% of your processes. Okay? Some companies are achieving that, but in most of the cases today, companies who are using electricity, and especially renewable electricity, are facing a need for flexibility. So in order to manage flexibility, digital comes as the right solution to balance supply and demand and to integrate the maximum dose of green energy into energy consumption. And all this is now having a return on investment that is pretty fast. All the solutions we implement with electricity and digital have a return of investment that is less than 5 years. Okay? So I'm going to bring you to what we learn into those 20 years journey, starting with meters, basically, and SCADA, and going into where we are today, which is the capability to offer solutions that are really digital and that integrate power at the center of building industrial processes, and even at the center of some what we call microgrid. Last message before I go into what we learned in this journey, we saw an incredible acceleration at the time of COVID, right? Means we developed those solutions. Some of them were ready on the shelf, I would say, not that much used. What we have witnessed over the last 2 to 3 years is just these transformations towards IoT and digital solution has accelerated in an incomparable way. And now we have many customers that ask us about help us to to remove people out of our operations, help us to remote control, help us to train our people with digital tools, and I will give you some example of the things we develop thanks to digital that was not at all where we started with. And last but not least, we have a lot now of people that want control of remote operating centers of their plants because they experienced that during COVID and they want to be able to have somehow dashboards that allow them to control what they do. Of course, the most use case we have today is operation center for energy. Means we're able today for some companies to give them the control of 10 plants in terms of energy resources. And we can offer to companies today dashboards that allow to visualize your energy consumption, your progress 1 year on the other, and eventually go up to your CO2 footprint of the full company. Few lessons I want to share around this journey of 20 years. And frankly, my goal here is not to teach anything, but more to share what we learn. And each of the things, there is good and bad. So I'm going to try to explain what was good and what was bad. The first lesson has been around architecture. When we started this journey of digital, we had a dream, which is let's make sure all our products are connected. Guess what? After 20 years, we're still not perfect, right? We have improved a lot, but it has been the most difficult part of the journey. It started, of course, and that's pretty important, it started by an alignment on leadership, means where we want to go, and we were, I mean, not a very large company at that time, but 20 years ago, we were already a decent-sized company, and we had a lot of acquisitions. By the way, over the last 20 years, we continue doing acquisitions. Integrating all that into a common framework has been extremely complex. What has drive us around this journey is speaking to the customers and try to understand how they wanted the solution, and we did a lot of experimentation with our customers. We ended up with something that we called EcoStruxure, which is a name that we put on the market, which gave to all our team a framework of integrating their digital products. You can be at level one, which is basically the IoT level. You can be at level two, which is somehow the plant layer, or at level three, which would be a cloud layer. What we give to our teams is basically a framework so that they are able to understand in which way they developed a product and how this product will interact with another layer from EcoStruxure. So we branded that first internally, and then we ended up branding it externally. And by doing that, we have been able to integrate our products together and offer to customers solutions that were really what they wanted to have, like control of downtime, like eventually reporting of information at plant level or at corporate level, with a lot of distinctive capabilities. We are not completely where we wanted to be, I have to be honest. If someone would have asked me the question 20 years ago, how long will it take you to do that? Probably we would have answered 5 years. It took us 20 years. Okay, and we're not completely there yet. Means why? Because we acquire company. And each time we acquire company, going into a framework that is already predefined is complex. Means there is a lot of reason not to go into this framework. So it's a journey that took us pretty long. And we always use the customer angle to assess the way our layers are working. Means what our team was telling us was important, but what the customers were telling us was extremely important in this journey. The second learning is we started on a domain where we had the expertise, and we had basically expertise around electricity, and we had expertise around automation of processes. So we basically took those two domains where we consider we had some legitimacy, and we ask our team to work on solutions where those two domains could go along together. Means we could use process control to optimize energy usage. We could use energy monitoring to be able to give information to process control. That's where we started. Basically, we tried a set of things that were pretty far from these bases, and it didn't work, right? So we tried solutions that we killed because it didn't work. We had created digital capabilities around things where we were not legitimate. Means customers were finding it very interesting, but we were not selling it because it was not close enough to our legitimacy. The third thing I want to share with you today is we unleash a lot of potential by using what we were doing with our own people. Okay, and the first area where we started to use our solutions has been our own office building and our own premises. Means we went to our plants, we say, hey, we explained to the customers that there is potential to save energy in the range of 30%. Let's try to do that in our plants. Okay, and it was 15 years ago. Pretty disruptive, I would say, because a lot of resistance for our plant people on installing our solution. When we engage them into the story, we first have got an incredible return on our own solutions, because our plant people were very open on what works and what does not work, probably even sometimes more than our customers. So we implemented a lot of connected capabilities into all our plants. Our track record has been impressive. I mean, we reduced our usage of power of 25% in most of the plants, okay? And we compare that to a base that is pretty old now. Means we grow our business, but we permanently optimize the use of energy. The second thing that popped up more recently is when all our products have been equipped with digital capabilities, we had our field service people, means the people who are going on the field supporting our equipment, that say, hey, I can use your digital capability with my mobile phone to be able to operate it more safely around the product, especially to maneuver the product before I intervene on the product. And you all know that an operation on electricity requires specific qualification and can be extremely dangerous if not made properly. So we decided to develop, along with our product offer, and it was a requirement from our people, all the capability to operate power remotely. Okay, so today in our offer, you have a full range of capability to operate power without touching the products, right? This was a requirement from our own people saying it can be safer to do that if I do it remotely. So it's two examples of the things where associating our people into the digital journey has brought us a lot of experiments and solutions. If now I go to another thing, is that we learn in this digital transformation that there are things you can be good at and there are many things that you cannot do by yourself, right? So when you end up speaking to customers, you have a lot of needs and digital, and I will come back on that, digital is unlocking a lot of potential opportunities, obviously. So you have permanent requests from your users saying, yeah, but it's great what you do, but I would like to do that. So we decided 5 years ago to not do everything by ourselves because we could not answer to all the needs. And we ended up partnering and sometimes even acquiring companies that would help us in our purpose, which is around bringing sustainable solutions to control electricity. So you see here a few examples of companies that we associated. Some of them have now joined the Schneider Group, some are kept independent, but those companies are now working and operating into our ecosystem. Means we decided not to develop with our own team. What we developed is simply interfaces in a logic that keep IoT level, enterprise level, site level and enterprise level. So basically, of course, we worked as well with obvious partners like Microsoft, Amazon, and so on, but we associated companies that were in our domain, which is the electrical field, right? And that had great capabilities that we decided to work with those companies instead of developing those internally. And when you do that, the wheel is accelerating, means you have customers that keep asking you for more. And we had a big request from some customers on, well, now that I have optimized my installation, that I have reached energy saving, and currently people are getting 30% of savings. They want to go one step beyond, which is to model what they could achieve if they, for example, electrify their processes. Means many processes are today burning gas or fuel or whatever it is. And we have many customers that have told us, well, I've saved already a lot on my energy consumption, but eventually I can electrify. I can go further with electricity. Before doing that, I need you to help me to simulate. So we went into basically the market. We could probably have developed something by ourselves, but it would not have been fast enough. So we went and we decided to develop in partnership with an American company called ETAP. We decided to develop a complete digital electrical twin of the installation in a way that we can today simulate, store, and architect the development of electricity into whatever industrial installation, into whatever microgrid and so on. So we end up building capabilities, and thanks to digital, we unlock new domains that are today domains of the future. Means as I speak, I consider that we prepare the company to help customers in the energy transition by partnering with company. And we have more and more of those companies who come to us and say, hey, let's work together and see how we could better architect the energy of the future. I'm going to bring you now into a few examples of what we have achieved. And the best way is not me to speak, is that getting a few illustrations from our customer. Of course, we achieved a lot, and I think we have been recognized for that. We achieved a lot in the field of energy efficiency and sustainability. 20 years journey, we implemented ourselves. Now we are able to advise customers on their sustainability journey. Means we are able to help a company on driving their journey towards sustainability. We started with energy efficiency. We have extended now to the complete field of sustainability, and we are able to advise companies. I want to give you another example which has nothing to do with the initial intent of energy efficiency, which is helping companies to better control their process. And here I'm going to show you a very short movie of what we achieved with Nestlé not far from here. And I think the movie speaks by itself.
Nestlé Toluca Cafés es la fábrica de café soluble más grande del mundo. Una falla eléctrica afecta duramente a nuestros procesos. EcoStruxure Asset Advisor me permite monitorear mis equipos en tiempo real. Me permite atender cualquier problema más rápido antes de que ocurra. Confiabilidad significa saber que todas las familias mexicanas van a tener una taza de café por las mañanas.
That's a pretty simple example. That's a customer who was asking us reliability and remote monitoring of their power distribution, right? Because the more you use electricity, the more it's critical that it works, right? And in Nestlé, they decided pretty early in their sustainability journey to replace other sources of energy by electricity. The consequence of that is that you wanted to work 100% of the time. We basically decided with Nestlé to implement monitoring solution on their plants. So we decided to do that. We implemented it with them, okay? Now they are monitored by a bureau of Schneider Electric, but basically we call their teams on site saying, hey, we think you have a problem on this part of your installation, please check. They accepted to do this movie for a very simple purpose, is that we avoid probably a 10-hour shutdown into one of their plants, okay, by remote monitoring. And of course, if all your plant is powered by electricity, and I will come back on that because we believe that's where the future is to have plants that are fully powered by electricity, of course, you'd better take care of the fact that your electricity is permanently available. Okay, so let's go into what's next, right? I think I've been clear on this 20 years journey, on what we learned, on the failures we did, and frankly, we, in all this story of putting digital with our products and with our team, we did a lot of failures. Means I told you, we thought in 5 years the things will be done. It took us 20 years. We still have a lot on our plate. The good point is that it prepares the company for the challenge of tomorrow. And thanks to digital, we have unlocked capabilities to our companies that probably we would not have unlocked without digital. Look at what we consider today is the biggest opportunity for most of us. Of course, you understand that we all are in a journey to decarbonize, reduce our CO2 footprint at plant level, at office level. You see here that electricity, which is today the very obvious solution to decarbonize for many, many reasons, flexibility, green generation, and so on. We see here that electricity is still a small part of the energy usage in industry, right? And where we probably, as all collectively, the biggest challenge is to introduce much more electricity into the industry processes. I'm not dreaming that electricity would be 100% everywhere, but we consider that we probably can move from 22%, which is where we are today, to 72%. So there is 50% of what you see here in gray that can be accessible with electricity. And if you consider that in most of the industry today, where people are using more electricity, they are producing renewable on sites, which is not something that is unfeasible, which are solutions that have a quick return on investment, most of the processes we see today are probably able to integrate up to 30% of renewable energy into their energy consumption. It means they don't source on the grid, they produce by themselves 20 to 30% of locally produced energy. We have a huge potential with solar, sometimes with wind, on site. Okay, not in central solar farm and central wind farms that all countries are now investing massively, but we have a huge potential on site. And in order to address this potential, you need to be able to maximize your own production into what you use in your process. And that's where we want to go. That's the next big challenge for all of us, I believe, is being able to maximize the integration of renewable production at the point of consumption. Basically, because by doing that, you reduce significantly the carbon footprint. Industry, many people speak about transportation, okay, in terms of carbon emission. We all need to know that building and industry are the two first areas of carbon emission. So we can look at transportation, we can complain about airplanes and ships and whatever it is, but the biggest potential is between, of course, renewable generation with large plants, but then using at the consumption point, at the consumer point, using at maximum renewable and electricity to replace fossil fuel. So that's where we decided to unlock the new potential, and all our solutions for the future will be to assemble digital capabilities to be able to maximize at the local point the use of renewable. Of course, it will require a lot of flexibility, because renewable is intermittent by design. So by doing that, if you want to achieve 20, 25% of your own production into your processes, you need permanently to deal with flexibility and digital capabilities. Frankly, 20 years ago, nobody would have told you this story at Schneider. Nobody. Okay? But we, thanks to the effort we did in digital, we have put our company with our customers to be now able to address those type of needs for the future. Few messages to conclude with. The first thing is when you go into a digital transformation, you need to have a purpose. It took us a bit of time, but our initial purpose was energy efficiency, was contributing to saving energy because we knew it would be one of the challenges. Frankly, this brought us far, I would say, but starting with a purpose is extremely important. It engaged your own team, means you don't do digital for the purpose of digital. You do digital for a purpose, which is what your company is doing. Of course, digital, and you understand it with what I presented, digital unlock a lot of possibilities, and especially partnership possibilities. Initially, when you develop products, you don't really partner. I mean, you look at other companies, eventually they are your competitors or not, but you don't really partner in the product field. When you enter into the field of digital, partnership really accelerates. That's what we experience. And last but not least, it brings obviously to your company much more opportunities. Link with your purpose, your digital transformation, and you will unlock a lot of opportunities. Just to conclude my speech, I want to bring you into what we think will be industry in the future with what I explained. And here as well, I'm going to illustrate that if it works with a movie.
The industry of the future is calling. And we're answering. With truly open automation to fuel the next generation of efficient, resilient operations. With practices that protect our planet and empower the ones bringing tomorrow's industry to life today. The industry of the future is open. Are you in? Life is on.